feels nice though.
That's nice.
He wants to go to his daddy. The boys are just too close to each other. Daddy, please take your son. I think I just carried him in the belly and I just gave him to my husband that this is your son.
Finished now.
Oh, cool.
So that's the kind of brown color what you really like for the crispy on the outside.
Peekaboo. It's gonna start again. Why you have tears in your eyes? Because you want the cartoons on? Oh, Daddy's fixing it for you, she? But Daddy has to fix it for you. You have to be patient. You see? There you go.
Oh, 1 second. It's not good,
Again, he's gonna start crying.
Protection.
Peekaboo. Peekaboo. Thank you, Daddy.
Peekaboo. Yeah.
Peekaboo. So Ethan was crying because he wanted to watch his cartoons, and we are going to be preparing to cook now. Ethan. So this is the Polish thing. Kids are now on this stage learning Polish. Daddy. All right, so welcome to our kitchen.
Well,
and yeah,
the living room will be next, guys. So just wait and see the living room.
Oh, you want to see what Ethan is doing, and Daddy and Mommy are gonna be cooking. So
why?
Well, because you want us to cook quickly, isn't it? Are you not starving?
Me, yes, I do.
I'm starving.
I already had my breakfast. I can't have my dinner after breakfast.
No, you didn't have breakfast, honey. After school snack you had.
When is gonna be my breakfast? Who stole my breakfast?
And of course,
meatballs.
Of course, there's always some kind of attention seeking in our house. This is the biggest attention seeking. The biggest attention seeker in our house
is Daddy.
No, I thought that you
I
only
seek so much of attention that it's
from your
shows.
Wife, isn't it?
Yes.
Daddy's not the biggest attention seeker in our house, only from his wife.
I know it's the most least attention seeking.
All right, guys.
Yes.
You are attention seeking, isn't it, Mali?
No.
Maybe you're the least.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I might be the least. Because Daddy's the...
Mommy, don't burn
Sorry.
Cables. Yeah.
Okie dokie.
Don't burn the cables.
All right, we are starting, guys.
We ready?
Yeah, ready.
Today, I'll be doing Kotlety Mielone, which is means escalopes, I think. Okay. Did one nicely say?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm doing them my way. So first I need to fry some onion.
That is the onion.
Yes.
Oh, I forgot again, honey. Sorry. My camera got foggy again.
Did it go foggy again?
No, it didn't. Oh, I'm just saying the first time. Yeah. But then I pointed on your onions.
Yeah, so onions will go into the mince, but after they're slightly fried, because then if we don't fry them now, and we put them inside the mince and then cook them as scallops, the onion will be raw inside, and that's not going to be too tasty. So I want the onion to be nicely cooked. And then... Now the mince, we have loads of mince.
Yeah.
We put some spices inside. And I'm usually adding a little bit of beef cube. Stock cube.
This is stock cube?
Stock cube, yeah. For making beef stock. just a little bit of it for the taste.
Yeah.
Not too much because I'm not making.
Oh no! Stuff. Come to mommy. I'll hold you.
Then now we need to add some spice to that,
mm-hmm.
and this is seasoning for mincemeat.
Mm, yeah.
I see. So.
What is it called?
Sweet pepper. It has some coriander. It has a little bit of garlic, but not enough.
Mm.
It's got white mustard, marjoram, because this is like almost 1 kilo of mince.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just gonna add all of it. Because this spice is for just half a kilo. So,
yeah.
In the meantime, our onion is kind of...
burning?
Yeah, getting there slowly. I think it was not put evenly on the stove.
It needs to be slightly brownish, isn't it, honey?
Yeah, yeah. So, now, sorry.
No.
Oh, Ethan wants to go. Go.
Go,
good.
Ethan. Go, go, go.
So, Emmanuel, you can go now? Yes? Thank you.
The boys.
Ethan, follow your
Thank
brother.
You.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
We managed to get rid of them.
Okay.
Bye,
so
honey's bears.
To that mixture, you add eggs. That's enough. That's enough. Now we need to cool it down. Cool down our onion. Now we add eggs, one egg, and second egg. The egg will act as a bonding agent.
Mm-hmm.
We'll bond everything together. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then we add some breadcrumbs.
Mm-hmm.
Breadcrumbs. I think 1 spoon of breadcrumbs, or maybe a little bit more.
All right, so we'll show you guys what we eat. Maybe you want to try our meals as well. You can do it at home yourself. And funny enough, I've noticed, honey, like some people, they prefer cooking vlogs. And, well, we find ourselves, well, we might as well be showing sometimes when we do cook. So Happy is mixing the mince with that onion that we are kind of like making a little bit brownish.
Yeah,
I'll just show you guys
how
it looks like that. So you put all the ingredients in the bowl. And you just mix it. So in our house, we have certain dishes that I call him daddy sometimes because he's my baby daddy. Sometimes daddy cooks the meals that he is really good at, and there are sometimes I do cook my meals that I'm good at. So this is like of his favorite dishes that he does for us.
Definitely.
Sometimes I just want to be with my husband alone.
Yes.
Isn't it, daddy?
Yes. But we have children now, so that's out of the window.
I think that's the price for having children.
Yeah.
So that is smooshing it like that. Like you need to use your hands. Get in there, girls. Get in there, and gentlemen. Smoosh.
You can show it.
Oh, yeah, I can show it, actually. Like mixing that onion and
Everything is nicely mixed. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So nice.
Ms. Apios, did you wash your hands?
I wash my hands, I remove my ring. So that's
all
the
right.
only time when I remove my ring for smushing that thing. No, because then under the ring there could be some germs. So
that's
you just really need to, once you put your hands into the food, you need to make sure
that
they're clean.
You know what they say, we don't know where the hands have been.
Yeah. Okay.
So now we're going to do this. I cannot help Happy because I'm the camera woman today.
Yes.
So we're going to roll them.
Yeah, we're gonna roll them in portions. So you just grab them as big as they want. They will lose the volume a little bit while cooking. So you just can make them a little bit bigger than you want.
Mm-hmm.
About a quarter. They will reduce in size about a quarter.
Yeah.
So
we roll.
You roll them like that. Once they're cooked, they're gonna be a little bit like that. So once you've got them nicely in a bowl, nice generous bowl that is.
Mm-hmm.
I think. You dab them into the breadcrumbs and you just rotate them around like that nicely. Bam, bam, bam.
And then pat them.
That's it. And that's ready for frying.
Yeah. So that's how it should look after you've covered it in the...
Yeah.
What is that?
In breadcrumbs.
Yeah.
Breadcrumbs, yeah. Sometimes it's hard to buy breadcrumbs.
Mm.
I know it's not a common ingredient, but you can use any... old bread, you can even like dried bread, you can even smash that into breadcrumbs, and use that. It's quite good stuff.
So you just keep on making those balls until you have all of them.
Yeah, you just keep on making until you run out of mints.
Yeah.
Oh, this is quite a lot of mints, which is nice. I like them when they're a bit bigger.
Yeah.
Morning, Ethan's coming.
Mm. Yeah, you just make them flat, kind of squash them in.
Yeah.
Once they like that, a bit squashed, it's faster for them to cook once they're a little bit squashed.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. You can also, for this dish, you can add to them, well, whatever you wish, really.
Mm.
Mushrooms, you can put mushrooms inside if you want. Anything that will go well. So, they're meant to be a part of a dish. So as a filler, you use potatoes or rice, because in our house we like to eat potatoes and rice.
Yeah.
We got to have today a bit of
potatoes and rice.
And rice. That one big. Either I do a big one or I do two small.
Two small ones. That will be eating for each one of us.
Okay. All right. So I'll do that. Allergies are starting. My nose is running.
All right, my love. So we'll eat your snowfish.
I don't have anything to.
You want me to give you something to wipe you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's not a good hygiene food handling, Mr.
No,
Chemist. So this is how they look, and we have to finish doing everything. So yeah.
It's tricky.
Mm-hmm. So now you just have to make sure you fry them.
Two frying pans on them.
Because it's much faster.
You set them on. On kind of medium flame, a bit slow, because you don't want to burn them outside and get them raw inside. So the flame needs to be low and fry them for a longer time on both sides until they're slightly brown. And then if you want crispy on the outside, you increase the flame and you flame them one side and then second side quickly before the serving. So they'll be hot inside and nice crispy outside.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway, we'll show you guys how they look, isn't it, honey?
Yeah.
You are not gonna be lifted by daddy. That's an order and that's a command from your mummy.
Alright.
That's how Ethan disrespects me.
It smells pretty nice.
I know.
I just want to eat it.
I know.
Right now, it's making me hungry. Oh, I don't eat it now. Maybe eat the baby food.
Ethan is busy driving his car.
Oh, we have like lots of cars.
Today we really want to say something, isn't it, my darling?
Yeah.
So the potatoes are cooking in there.
Yeah.
And they are kind of like shimmering a little bit like that. Like Happy said, they really need to be on low heat.
Yeah.
And I don't know why Happy is cutting some onions for.
Onion will be to fry it slightly for golden and to sprinkle it on the potatoes once I mash them.
Yeah.
With that sauce that is gonna extract from that beef.
Yeah.
Well, because it's just to close them up so they fry on one side and the other. Come on, flip nicely.
So we're just gonna let them cook. Usually they take like how many minutes?
I need to keep them like that for 10 minutes.
Yeah, because it's really...
For one side. 10 minutes one side, 10 minutes other. Mm. And then you can actually serve them once you see that they're not pinky on the side. You can slice one in a half if you're not sure.
See, Daisy, you're right, honey.
All right. Push them down a little bit, what I say.
Push them.
Yeah, so just squeeze out the workout.
So it's almost done. This is how golden brown it is.
Yeah.
Ethan wanted to be lifted up by daddy.
It's hot.
Is it brown?
Yeah.
Is it meat?
Bardzo gorące, tak. Nie dotykaj. Nie, bo przyspadzisz.
O.
Let him sleep in on you.
I tried to put him to sleep. Oh. He wouldn't go to sleep.
Oh, sleepy baby. Come, let's have a look.
He wants to sleep next to you.
I've been working hard today.
Can I put you to sleep?
What? You want to go to sleep?
Can I just put you to sleep? He doesn't want to sleep.
Daddy.
You want to come to me? Is it only Daddy can put him to sleep? I can put you up. Ethan. I can put you to sleep because I'm your mommy. He thinks I don't know how to put him to sleep. Like I was carrying this baby for 9 months.
Mommy, I don't think anybody will hear you over the squirting of the meat. Yeah, they're finished now.
Oh, cool.
So that's the kind of brown color what you really like when they're crispy on the outside.
Yeah.
And nice and brown.
Yeah. So I'm running out of battery. Boys are just too close to each other. Daddy, please take your son. I think I just carried him in the belly and I just gave him to my husband that this is your son. Actually, what Ethan does, if Dad is at home and he kind of like, he'll be spending so much time with his daddy, then he'll be more close to his daddy on that particular day. Again, when his daddy goes to work and I spend time with him, then he'll be more close to me. So it's like that. So today the boys woke up early in the morning and they were spending some time together and then they are now like love beds, you see?
Yeah. He wants to touch this.
He wants to touch. Hot, hot.
It's hot. It's hot. It's gorące. It's bardzo gorące, się sparzysz. Tak. A będzie bolało.
Ouch.
Będzie bolało później, będzie au. Au.
He knows what hot means. All right, guys, so we are going to be enjoying our meal and you can eat this with anything. Actually, you can eat, like Happy said, you can eat it with mashed potatoes or you can eat it with rice or you can just eat it like that. It depends what you like. That's like a proper chef. So that's the fried rice. That's the fried rice.
Oh, slightly fried. Yeah.
Do you like rice, Ethan? Mm? What do you like? He even wants to go to his brother. Because he knows his brother is going to get him down. Then he's going to be able to reach for go to his dad.
Again,
huh? You want potatoes or rice?
A bit of potatoes and rice. Yeah, actually, honey, you like the rice.
Still some potatoes left, so I'll leave them on the frying pan.
You're gonna love the rice, honey. It's so nice.
Oh, no, it's so nice.
Basmati rice is really nice.
Potatoes should be nice too. Today I'll be doing cotolette milone. Which is means escalopes.
So this is the Polish the kids are now on this stage learning Polish.